Video 2.3, the Azure Face Detection Model. In this video, we will cover the following topics: how to specify a face detection model, an example application using the face detection model, use cases of face detection models. In this video, we will visually observe the deployment of face service by Azure Vision Services. For this project, we'll use Microsoft Azure's Cognitive Services Face API and Python to identify, count, and classify people in a picture. By the end of this video, you should be able to use these examples to further explore Azure's cognitive services with Python and incorporate them into your own projects. The best part about Azure Cognitive Services is that there is no need to understand the technology that is used behind the scenes, because the cognitive services APIs provide a relatively easier way to use this pre-trained AI framework for our own problems. All that we need to do is setting up an account in Azure and using the REST API to process your data. Face API is used to determine many elements of a person's face in picture, including number of faces in the image and where they are located. Traits of the faces, such as identifying if the person is wearing glasses, has makeup or facial hair, etc. Predict the gender and age of the faces in the image. The emotions conveyed by the face, like happiness, neutral, anger, contempt, disgust, fear, sadness, or surprise. Identify the individuals and determine if two different pictures are of the same person. In simple words, there's a lot of power in this API and it can easily be accessed using Python. In this project, we will detect the faces in the image, predict the gender and age of the detected faces in the image, and also return the traits and emotions of the faces. Let's see how this is done step by step. Now, let's look at the code. We have imported all the libraries and packages that we require in this part of the code. Remember to download the face client library using the command line pip install upgrade Azure Cognitive Services Vision Face in your console. Next, make sure to assign the API key and appropriate endpoint API URL that we have seen on the Azure portal page previously. An important point to note with the URL is that the endpoint is this, but the actual URL needs to include the API information, that is, in this case, this one, and that's what we'll be using. In order to streamline the process and annotate images, I have created an annotate image function that can take a local file or pass a remote URL, then show the detected faces by the algorithm. Let's look into the function now. The subscription key is passed to the header variable as shown here, and we are given the params variable to display face ID and face attributes like age, gender, smile, pose, emotions, facial hair, wearing glasses or not, etc. If-else statements given here are to check if the given image is from our local desktop or from the internet in the form of a URL. The response of all the output is displayed in JSON format. Now, a for loop is given to pass each face from the image that we have given. The face landmarks and face attributes are used to predict the age and gender of the faces, as seen here in this part of the code. Now the function has come to an end, and we have successfully created our face detection model. Let's give our input image and check for the output. The image that I have given is that of me with my cousins. Now let's look at the output. As we can see, 5 of the faces have been detected by the rectangular boxes, and the gender, age attributes have been predicted. Gender of all the faces are predicted correctly, but the age predicted is acceptable enough, but not highly accurate. Also, we can observe that the face in the leftmost part of the image is not detected, as it is too small to be considered. So keep in mind that the faces should cover a fair amount of pixels in the image in order to be detected. Now let's look at the traits and emotions that have been predicted for each face. Each face is assigned a unique ID, and the attributes attached to each are displayed in JSON format. The values shown are well accurate, as we can see with my face that beard and mustache have been detected, but not for my other cousins. The number of faces detected in the image is also shown. So, as we can see, I had to only write the code to pass a valid URL of an image, give the credentials that are key, endpoint, and the parameters to control the output. All the machine learning and training stuff are looked after by the Azure Face API of Azure Vision Services. Now, let us see where we can use these services. Apps like Facebook and Instagram use face detection models to help the user tag faces in an image. It is also used for security purposes, like authorizing people's entry into stadiums, offices, and other public places. Even Uber has recently started using the Azure Vision services to authorize their drivers to provide safer travel for their customers. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: how to specify a face detection model, an example application using the face detection model, use cases of face detection models. In the next video, we learn about the Azure Face Verification model.